name is KAY Felix, and I welcome you to KAY Felix Inspire. Always remember, if you're coming here for the first time, please don't forget to subscribe. Hit the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I post new videos. Please do stay tuned for more details in this video.
We believe in courage. We believe that without courage, there's nothing you can achieve. It doesn't matter what vision, what dreams you have, you need to have courage. So we are courageous. We are not intimidated by anybody whatsoever. Whether the source of possible intimidation is our political opponents in the opposition or the government of the day, and it doesn't matter whether that government of the day is the Patriotic Front, which left, or the new government, which is the Upnd administration. We are not intimidated, and we shall never be intimidated. So if there's anybody out there who has any ideas to say we are going to intimidate the Patriots for Economic Progress in general, or we are going to intimidate Sean Tembo, they should forget about it. Yes.
All right. Well, a bunch of incompetent people is what you call them. But of course, the Minister of Youth, Sport and Arts, of course, according to the Daily Nation paper today, has warned you, Mr. Sean Tembo, do not take the freedom of expression for granted. What is your reaction to that? Before we get into the reaction of the presidential radio engagement and interaction that happened on Wednesday, what's your reaction to...
You know, Shisha, there's this misconception by the UPND administration that people of Zambia exercise their freedom of expression, freedom of association, freedom of assembly, because the UPND government is actually giving them those freedoms. And I want to say this, I'll say it once, that is absolute nonsense, total nonsense. The freedom of expression, freedom of association, freedom of assembly that we enjoy as citizens in this country is something that is given to us by the Constitution of the Republic of Zambia. You understand? By the Constitution of the Republic of Zambia. The narrative which President Hichilema and his ministers have been driving, that the reason we speak the way we are speaking right here is because he has given us these freedoms, is total nonsense. Absolute nonsense.
Well, maybe
I want to make it clear.
Freedom of expression, Mr. Tembo.
I want to make it clear, Chisha, that we do not need to get any permission, and we do not need to receive any permission from the current government for us to be able to express ourselves. We don't, and we shall never. And if they think that we express ourselves because they allow us, then they should disallow us. Tell them to withdraw their permission for us to exercise our freedoms. Tell them to withdraw it right here and right now. Tell them to send the police to come and arrest me because I'm speaking about their government. I'm explaining to the people of Zambia how incompetent their government is. Tell them to withdraw that freedom if they feel they are the ones who actually give it to us.
Yeah, so I do know for a fact that yes, it is backed by law, but would you enjoy the same freedoms in the previous regime?
We've been speaking since time immemorial. If the PF, during the PF regime, when the PF tried to stop us by sending the police, we took the police to court and we won the cases. So if the UPND administration wants to stop us, they can send their police and we'll sue their police also and we'll win in court. And I want to tell the president right here and right now, I want to tell President Hichilema, if he thinks he's the one giving us the freedom of expression that we are enjoying right here and right now, let him withdraw that freedom of expression right now. Let him send his policemen to come and arrest me. And I want him to do it tonight. Let him withdraw. We don't need his permission. We don't want him to give us any permission to express ourselves. Since he thinks he's the one who gives us that permission, we don't need that permission.
All right, let's go to the assessment of the radio engagement that the president did have on Wednesday. You know, on the 13th of October, 2021, he did have a radio engagement at State House on a particular radio station. What's your assessment as Patriots for Economic Progress and as Sean Tembo, the president that's leading that political party?
Well, for us, particularly, Chisha, we find it extremely regrettable that The president is spending a lot of time talking and very little time, you know, making his talk reality, realizing the promises that he made. So far, he's been in office for some time and he hasn't realized a single promise that he made, not a single one of them. He's always talking when he was in the opposition, like any opposition leader, he was always in the media, he was always making promises, all sorts of promises. Yeah. No one ever compelled him to make those promises. It was him and him alone who was saying that when he's sworn in the morning, in the afternoon, the dollar will appreciate. It is him and him alone who was saying if he's voted into office in the morning, in the afternoon, he'll sell the presidential jet and use that money to pay meal allowances for students. You understand? It is him. No one put a gun to his head. No one did that. It was him, out of his own volition. It was him and him alone who told the farmers, the Zambian farmers, that the moment he is actually elected into office, he is going to buy their maize at 250 kwacha. It is him, not anyone else, not Sean Tembo. No, I didn't compel HH to make those promises. So today, when we wake up and we tell the Zambian people to say, this man, the promises he made to you, he's not fulfilling them. He's running away from them. Each one of those promises. Then why should he come to us and tell us that you are abusing the freedom of expression which HH is giving us? HH doesn't have any freedom of expression to give to any Zambian. He doesn't have any freedom of expression.
We've moved from the freedom of expression. We're looking at the assessment.
So on that particular speech, you know, at the end of the day, any president will run their presidency in the manner and fashion that they see fit. So it's not for me, really, to tell HH to say, look, you need to spend so much time in office with your cabinet ministers so that when you go out there, you are not speaking different languages, whereby one is saying cutters are encouraged, you are saying not. Others are saying roadblocks are cancelled, you are saying they need to be brought back. Spend more time with your cabinet, agree on the policy of government, so that when you go out there, if a minister makes a ministerial statement, it should be based on the discussions they had in cabinet. You understand? It's not for me to tell him that. He needs to be able to figure it out. But me as an opposition leader, it's my job to hold him accountable on the fulfillment of his promises. You understand? And our point is that he's spending more time making additional promises instead of him actually fulfilling the promises that he has already made to the Zambian people. Take, for instance, what he was talking about on Radio Phoenix a few days ago. The president was talking about how wonderful his 2022 national budget is going to be. And he's been talking about that for a long time. He started with that narrative, and then at some point, his minister said, no, the 2022 budget will be a PF budget with a few adjustments from the UPND. You understand? That shows inconsistency. Then again, the president comes and says, no, the 2022 budget will be our budget. And when we implement the new budget, then we'll begin to fulfill the promises we made to the Zambian people. So there's chaos. There's confusion in the UPND administration. You understand? And, you know, if I make a statement to say this government is a bunch of incompetence, I make that statement with a free conscience because the evidence is there for all to see. Provided you are not someone who is indoctrinated, you've got objectivity and an independent mind, you can see that this government is totally, you know, it's got no direction. It's not going anywhere. It's not going to take the people of this country anywhere.